Last video, we figured out how to overwrite certain functions with LD preload and how to access the internal objects from libgamelogic. With that, we were able to increase our walking speed a lot. So let's see what else we can do. One really cool thing would be flying, right? Flying. So how could we get flying? There's obviously not an attribute in the player class to simply enable flying, but we can maybe be creative with what we have. And jumping is definitely close to flying. We just can't fly very high, and we will fall back down. So maybe we can make something out of that. I've noticed there's a jump hold time and jump speed. So let's set jump speed to a high value and check what it does. Let's compile our evil library. Then we LD preload it into the game and let's see what changed. When we now jump, okay, I think the speed was a bit too crazy, but we get a nice view of the map, including an island? We haven't found that island during our Let's Play in episode 1. I wonder what we can find there. So let's tone down the speed a bit and I'll also add the jump hold time with a higher value. Then we can try it again. Okay, so jumping seems fairly normal. Except that I can keep space pressed, or you know, hold space for a longer time, and then I keep rising up. That's pretty cool flying already. But the issue is that once I release space again, we start falling down and we can't jump anymore until we touch the ground again. This is kind of the challenge with game hacking. We have essentially all the power of the world. We can modify any memory, call any function we want, we just need to be creative with what and how we do it, so we can make it usable and fun. So when I was looking around a bit more, I found that the player class has a function called canJump, which returns a boolean true or false. So let's try to overwrite that function and always return 1. When we now try this in game, we can fly up when we press space, decline when we release it, but we can also press it again to jump again and thus fly up. While the flying is not perfect because the player has an awful velocity while in the air, it's still pretty neat. If anybody finds a way to be able to move horizontally as if you were walking on ground, let me know. Let's fly a bit higher to see again in which direction the island was. So cool. The island looks awesome from above. Oh, there's a dark spot over there. Is that the island? Enhance. It could be the island. Let's fall back to the ground, which takes a little bit, but then thanks to our super speed, we just quickly run there. We are approaching it. Island, here we come. Entering cow bungalow. Oh look, there's a chest and the cow king. Remember the gold farm from Let's Play in episode 1? Welcome to gold farm. I farm all day to provide for this island, but it has all gone wrong. What's wrong? My cows are missing. One night I heard a massive amount of thunder, then my cows had disappeared. I have no idea where they went. I will let you know if I see them. Okay, until cows come home, find the lost cows. So sounds like we found the cows. Ouch, the cow king just killed us. Damn, with the attack static link. It's a 1337 magic spell and dealing a lot of shock damage. Let's respawn and check out that house here. Welcome to my humble bungalow. I was enjoying my private island until those mad cows showed up. Where did the cows come from? One night I heard a thunderous boom and when I looked outside there were mad cows everywhere. There's one in particular that worries me. That sounds familiar. I think I know who owned these cows. Which one worries you? The one with the crown. Anything that gets close gets struck by a bolt of lightning out of the blue. Do you know any magic? I do. Why do you ask? I have a legendary magical cube here. I read that it possesses typo, here's a typo, literally unplayable. I read that it possesses the power of the fable Rubik and might be able to steal the thunder of the cow king, leaving it defenseless. Have you tried to use it on the cow? I would, but I'm terrible with magic. My last attempt got me stranded on this island. That fast travel spot right here is such a tease, as whatever magic got me here is preventing me from using it. Would you please take the cube and try it? I will take it and try to use it. Here it is. I won't need it back. No more magic for me. Good luck. Now go steal the cow's king's thunder. Thank you. I will see what I can do. Acquired Rubik's cube. I am legend. And what the heck killed by a mad cow? Thank you. Okay, now let's go to the Cow King again. It's attacking me. Let's spam using the Rubik's Cube and I steal the Static Link skill. Now I can use Static Link. There we go. Quest complete. Until the cows come home. And a new achievement, Monster Kill. We also get a weapon, the Cowboy Coder. But let's check out the chest. Acquired Flag of the Cow. Lead flag. The key is, I should have used Dynamic Link. Woohoo! Our first flag! And if we would have found this during the CTF, we could now submit this flag to the scoreboard to get points for our team. Awesome! We are slowly making progress. Before we end this, maybe we could also take a quick look at the original list of challenges to get an overview what our goals are. This was a CTF page for the Ghost in the Shell Code CTF 2015, and here's the challenge we just solved. Until the cows come home. We could have gotten 100 points for that, and it was the easiest one. I think next time I try to go for unbearable revenge. By the way, if you want to follow along and try this out yourself, you can find all the files in the description of the videos.